Alright, hotep. It's none other than your brother, Professor Ace, Osiadan Borebore Oboadee, www.africancreationenergy.com. You know, as you know, I wrote this book, Architect, How to Build a Pyramid. Last year, I was doing this pyramid building project, and along with actually building the pyramid, I actually built what's called a Nubian vault and Nubian dome. I kind of hinted at it on the cover of the book. You know, you see a pyramid structure, but within the pyramid structure, you see the outline of what you would call an arch or a dome. You follow what I'm saying? Because the dome or the arch was like the motivating architectural achievement, a motivating architectural structure that I used to motivate the building of the pyramid. You know, I conceptualized being able to build a pyramid by crossing two arches. So this video is basically just showing the process of me building the arch, or building what they call the Nubian vault. Right now I'm basically building a frame out of wood. In the video, I built the planks or the spokes of the arch at different lengths, calculated by the equation of the Nubian vault. The Nubian vault is actually an architectural technique that you find throughout Africa, you know, in Sudan. There are examples of Nubian vaults in Egypt. You see those arches built in Egypt. And actually, before pyramids were ever built, you know, they built these domical beehive-shaped constructions. You know what I mean? In the book Black Genesis, they talk about the African or the Southern African, Central African civilization that spawned Egypt. They built these. They call them tumuli. You know, these dome-shaped houses, these beehive-shaped houses. So these different Nubian vaults and domes were built prior to pyramids. So these, you know, these round-shaped, oval-shaped, egg-shaped structures were built prior to pyramids ever being built. You know, and there's a lot of reasons for that. You know, the egg shape, first and foremost, you know what I mean? Nature doesn't build squares. You follow what I'm saying? Nature doesn't build squares. Nature builds circles naturally. You know what I mean? There are no natural instances of squares, so you know the pyramid had to actually be invented. But you know, these different dome-shaped constructions, you know, they're very strong. If you think about your rib cage, if you think about the egg that houses the fetus, whether it be a chicken egg or whether it be the egg inside the mother's body, you know, we all have these round-shaped structures. Nature builds these round-shaped structures because they are strong structures. Oh, and in this part in the video, my wood that I was supposed to stretch across the frame, it broke. It broke, and I had to I'm gonna say jerry rig, you know what I mean? That's what I had to come up with a way to try to fix it. So I put some hinges in between the pieces that broke. So, you know what I mean? This was my first time trying to build a Nubian vault, a Nubian dome, you know what I mean? But I had to do something real quick to try to salvage the construction of this frame. What I'm saying, so yeah, this is, you know, so within the book Architect, How to Build a Pyramid, not only do you get instructions for how to build a pyramid, but you also get instructions for how to build a Nubian vault or Nubian dome. You know, I was watching the movie Prometheus. And they were talking about the structure that they found, you know, on that alien planet, and they were calling it a pyramid throughout the movie. But if you actually look at the structure It was actually another domical shape structure, you follow what I'm saying? And I actually find it interesting that this is a architectural achievement. This is a feat of architecture that they actually give credit to Africans for. They actually call it Nubian vaults in many architectural literature. And so, I did this project for my 30th birthday. I turned 30 last year, getting grown. You follow what I'm saying? So I turned 30 last year. I was doing this project, to celebrate my 30th birthday. So I said, let me build a pyramid and build a Nubian dome. My wife came out and helped me out with the project a little bit. And so after doing this project, I've actually teamed up with several other brothers and sisters around the planet, around the globe, to work on some projects, man. So, African Creation Energy, we're going to be opening up a science, math, and technology academy here in Atlanta, Georgia. We actually teamed up with Benu Village out in West Africa, and we're going to be doing a pyramid project out there. And we also teamed up with the brothers at Tamaray 2 in North Carolina. You follow what I'm saying? We're going to be doing a project out there. And so, all these different projects, man, we're looking for volunteers. We're looking for recruits. You follow what I'm saying? The goal and objective is not to to have it cost anything for people to participate other than their time and energy. You follow what I'm saying? I think about, the Habitat for Humanity project. They get volunteers all the time. People don't necessarily have to have construction experience. They just have to have a will and desire to want to do the project, want to help out, and the ability to follow instructions. You follow what I'm saying? So, we're going to be spearheading these pyramid building projects in Atlanta, in North Carolina, and in West Africa. I'll be putting out a formal video, formal request for assistance in the weeks and months coming. But, if anybody's interested in taking part in the operative architectural manifestations of their African culture and want to help out with these projects, you can always send me an email at africancreationenergy@gmail.com. This is an opportunity to go down in history, Ideally, I'd like to have the same people help out with all three projects, you follow what I'm saying? Help out in ATL, help out in North Carolina, and help out in West Africa. But if you're only able to assist with one of the projects, that's beneficial too. You follow what I'm saying? So here I'm building the Nubian vault, I'm building the Nubian dome. It's basically, once you have the framework put up, you just lay the bricks across the wood frame. And if you look up at the top, you see where my piece broke off, man. Ever since that piece broke off, I really had a hard time trying to get it right. But eventually I did get it right. But you basically, once you do the math of it all and you get it, you get the arch at the correct angle, then you just lay the bricks across the arch, as I'm doing in the video. People who are familiar with different esoteric, different occult, secret societies that grew out of operative masonry, because building an arch was perhaps one of the more difficult tasks, or one of the more challenging tasks for people to accomplish, And, in these different occult societies, having the title of the Royal Arch, the Royal Arch degree is considered prestigious. It's one of the higher degrees in, these different esoteric occult societies. Yeah. So here I am, building the Nubian vault. And so what I'm going to do, after I fill in this vault, lay the bricks across, all the way across so that they connect. Then the next step is to lower the wood frame that's holding up the arch. And then to rotate it at a 90 degree angle, and then continue the process on that side as well. Hey! man, I had a hard time. So then, yeah, so then I had to go get a, I got a piece of metal. I got a piece of metal for the wood that broke, so I could fill it in and get the arch to connect, man. You know what I mean? Something else interesting that I found out about is these things called air wells. Now, air wells are like these domical shaped constructions, and they operate something like an atmospheric water generator. Basically, what they do is they're basically domes. They're beehive shaped domes built out of masonry, and they're designed in such a way that they facilitate the air to condense and create water. So they're actually like they're constructions that turn air into water. You follow what I'm saying? And so, and it, you know, they work very well in humid climates, in humid environments. And so I find that actually astonishing. And you have to wonder if the reason why, you know, our ancient ancestors favored building these vaults and building these domical structures was because, you know, they actually had the ability to facilitate the creation of water, condensing air into water. You know, that's another topic, another concept that I talk about, you know, in the book, Nine Ether Ray Engineering, that's coming up June 26th of this year. Yeah, and they also use these domical shaped structures as refrigerators in the desert, you know, in the Middle East, you know. So these structures actually have a lot of useful, these structures have a lot of uses, you know what I mean? They can be put to a lot of practical uses. Yeah, so here it is. I finally completed the arch. Got it across the piece of wood. I remember after I finished it, I was kind of nervous to remove the wood frame. I was like, man, when I take the wood frame out, this thing is gonna collapse, man. I was really nervous. You know what I mean? I think I let it sit for about a week or two before I decided to, you know, try to pull the wood frame from out of there. So here I am, you know, going in nervous. Take the wood planks off out of the bottom, unscrew them out of the bottom, you know, and then let the wood frame drop. It probably drop about 2 to 4 inches, you know, after the wood is removed from the bottom. And then I just slid it out, you know what I mean? You know, take out, and it slid right out, man. And I was shocked, and it was still standing. It didn't fall. I got to stand underneath the arch, you know what I mean? That's one of the esoteric symbolisms. You know, after you build the arch, you got to stand underneath it. You have to understand it. You follow what I'm saying? And actually in Nubia, there are pictures of young men, after they build their arch, they have to stand on top of the arch to show how strong it is. They have to overstand it. You know, literally overstand it. You follow what I'm saying? So yeah, it's a lot of symbolism in building these arches and building these Nubian domes. So yeah, after I slid the frame out, I rotated it 90 degrees, and then I began laying the bricks across that side, because I had basically two arches crossing at a 90 degree angle. And basically the same process as the first arch, you know. Once you get the frame in position, you just lay the bricks across. Try to keep them lined up. That's why I have my level out there, to keep them, you know, in a straight line all the way up. You know, just putting in work, man. You know, people who do work, you know, they don't really get a lot of fame, a lot of popularity. You know what I mean? But I noticed them, you know. Brothers like Neb Kara, man, I actually had the opportunity to speak with that brother. He bought my book, you know, as an elder brother, you know, and that's an honor to me, you know, because I'm relatively young. I'm 30, I'm young, but I'm not that young. Relatively young, new writer, you know what I mean? And I got, you know, elder brothers putting in work at Per Ankh University, you know, buying my book, man. That means a lot to me, you know what I mean? And I mean, people like, man, we got Imhotep Academy here in Atlanta. You know what I mean? You got the Karas Center for African Spirituality out in California, man. all these people, man, they do these great things. You know, they put together these great organizations. You know, they're well established. You know what I mean? But you don't necessarily know their name, or they don't necessarily get shout out. They don't get fame, popularity. You know what I mean? But they're putting in work. But you know, I show up. If they ever do a lecture telling us how to how they did what they did and how they managed to sustain what they do, you know, I show up. I'll be in the front row to support those lectures, man. So shout out to all the people that's putting in work that don't necessarily get the fame and popularity that goes along with it. So I completed the second arch. You know, now I'm trying to remove the wood frame from under there. You know, same process, pull out the wood at the bottom, let it drop, and slide it out. And at the end, I just broke it up because I wasn't going to use it anymore. And I had my Nubian vault, I had my Nubian dome. You follow what I'm saying? And you can see how when the two arches are crossing, you know, it actually resembles a pyramid-shaped structure. You know what I mean? You can actually continue with the same process to go ahead and fill in all the sides. You follow what I'm saying? But that's just a simple way of building Nubian vaults and Nubian dome. Again, that's a architectural that's an architectural style that is originated out of Africa. The arch degree, Nubia, the arch degree. So you know, as always, it's been none other than your brother, Professor Ace, Osiadan Borebore Oboadee, www.africancreationenergy.com. Creative Solution Based Technical Consulting, OTEC.